Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really awesome project. We are bleaching t-shirts and decorating with heat transfer vinyl. All right guys, so this is my shirt. It's a nice green shirt for St. Patrick's Day. And this is a Gildan soft style. It is 65% polyester and 35% cotton, which means that it's a really good choice for bleach shirts, especially if you do sublimation, because you can still bleach and you can still sublimate. Now, we are going to do this with heat transfer vinyl, but I just wanted to be able to show you this is a really good shirt option, and it is available for several different styles of bleach shirts, okay? Now, this is my two pages that I cut. Now, I used vinyl that I had on hand that was a little bent at the corners. Okay, I have a vinyl shop that I run here locally, and I save my vinyl that, is crinkled or damaged in any way, anything I can't sell, I save all that vinyl for stencils. So just keep that in mind next time you come across some vinyl in your crafting supplies, and just know that you can find alternate uses, and stencils are a great way to use that damaged vinyl. So that was just one pull, and then I will go in and peel out the inside pieces, but let's get this one started also. Now you don't have to weed this all at one time, but what I do is I just keep bunching up. I use one hand slash arm to hold my sheet down, and I just keep pulling, but notice I'm pulling up. I'm making sure to pull up, not back, not to the side, and that keeps my design from coming back down and sticking down on the rest of my vinyl. Now, if you really wanted to go heavy on the shamrocks on your design, then you could save all of these inside pieces. That's not what I'm going to do because I have a different plan in mind that I have in my head, but just know that you could be peeling these off more delicately and using them on your shirt. Two weeded designs. Now let's talk about how easy this is to put on your shirt, because we're literally just going to line this up. So what I can do, now you'll notice I do have, like, this is a small piece right here. I'm not going to worry about those. I'm not going to use those. And what I'm going to do, I'm also not going to use transfer tape. I'm just going to start in one corner and slowly peel this up. And I know you're going to ask, why am I not using transfer tape? That is because I find it easier to just lay this down on the shirt than to try to fight with the transfer tape to pull it back off. So completely up to you. If you are okay and you have good experiences using the transfer tape, then that's something that you can do. I just don't find that it releases very well when I'm trying to adhere the vinyl to the shirt. Okay, so this does stay intact pretty well. And what I can do is just line it up with my shirt and lay it in place. Okay, and once I do, just smooth out my shirt, push down on my vinyl, make sure that I get a good adhesion. Okay, so now we have the stencils down on our shirt, and let's talk about these other shamrocks that we cut out, and we're going to apply the same principle. We are just going to peel these off the back, and what I plan on doing, because my design will be front and center here, I'm going to use these just as accent pieces. So I will continue to adhere these down until I get the look that I'm going for. Okay, now one important thing to remember is I am still going to give some texture to the middle of my shirt. So I did not place any of my stencil designs on there. But now that we have adhered this vinyl, we're ready to go outside and start the bleaching.
Now, because we are using a polycotton blend shirt, I'm able to use straight bleach. Now, some crafters do dilute their bleach, and I do definitely recommend that if you're using a 100% cotton shirt. But for these blends, using the straight bleach has been fine for me. Now, I do try to do this on a sunny day. Luckily, I live in Florida, so you may have to be a little bit more flexible. I try to put mine on a surface. Obviously, I don't want to lay it flat on the ground. I use cardboard boxes for just about everything, and it's also a good idea to put a barrier in between the two layers on the inside of your shirt. That way your bleach does not soak all the way through to the backside. So make sure you go ahead and spray your stencils, and you can use as much or as little bleach as you want. Make sure you do have a spray bottle that is a spray and not a stream, unless a stream is the look that you're going for. So it can be difficult to tell when your bleaching process is finished because you're standing there slowly watching it happen. So it's okay to go ahead and peel the stencils back, but if you're sensitive to bleach, you may want to wear gloves because you will have bleach on your vinyl stencils that will get on your hands. Once you're sure that the bleaching process has completed, feel free to go ahead and take it inside. Now also, especially on cotton shirts, a lot of people will go ahead and soak their shirt in a mixture of water and peroxide. Again, I'm going to accredit it to using a blend shirt. I'm able to just wash mine in regular cold water. A lot of times I'll let it soak for a little bit, wring it out really well, and then hang to dry. And then after that, I'm free to apply my design. So let's take a look and see what that looks like.
All right, so let me show you how awesome this is. I think this turned out really, really good. Obviously, it's pretty heavy on the bleach in this entire area. Let me show you the original color. This is the color we started out. So really, really cool. I'll be honest with you guys, every time I go to do a bleach t-shirt tutorial, this is the second one that I've done for you. And I always doubt. I'm always like, I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna like it. And I'm not gonna lie, every time I absolutely love them. Love them. So I'm gonna go ahead and weed off this HTV. There's nothing special about this HTV. The reason that I'm showing you is my last bleach shirt that I showed you guys was made with sublimation. Now, this is, remember, it's a poly cotton blended shirt, so you could still absolutely use sublimation on this shirt. Just know that it's going to be not quite as vibrant because of the cotton content, but still, they turn out really, really well, especially this color. I've used this color before. Now, what I'm telling you this for is that I'm showing you that you do not have to use sublimation for these to look good. I want to show you that even just regular heat transfer vinyl, because what is giving your shirt so much character is the bleach, and especially in this case, the bleach design and the clovers on the shoulders, and it's just really, really darn cute, guys. I'm really, really happy with how this turned out. So now what I can do is just position this like I would any other design. And I went with green for my heat transfer vinyl because the shirt is so white. So I can really treat it about however I want to. I don't know if that really makes a whole lot of sense to you guys, but you know, you have to be more careful picking out your HTV color when you're putting it on a color shirt. So for example, if I was using a dark color shirt, then I would want to use a light colored vinyl. So we kind of did the opposite here. We don't have to use a light color vinyl because we changed the color of the shirt. So in situations where maybe all I had was green and a green shirt, well then bleaching may be a really good alternative for that. Also, I'm pressing at 320. For 20 seconds, 15 to 20 seconds, because that is what is dictated by the brand of heat transfer vinyl that I'm using. So definitely make sure you check with whatever brand is your preference and use the correct settings for that. There's absolutely nothing special required because you bleach the shirt first. Also, I have not washed this shirt first. I did rinse it out really, really good. Because it's a blend, I also did not have to treat it with peroxide. I used straight bleach and then rinsed it out whenever I was done, let it dry overnight, just hang dry. You could also throw it in your dryer if you wanted to. And now I am applying the heat transfer vinyl. After this is done and I'm happy with the project, of course, I will give it a full wash before I wear it. That way, if there's any residual bleach, I don't have to worry about it. And I do wash these shirts by themselves. So that is pretty much all the information you need to know about treating your bleach shirt. All right, and there we go. What do you guys think? Obviously, I absolutely love it. I love it. This is probably one of my favorite projects in a long time. I probably say that a lot, but I actually mean it. I do mean it. I love all my projects, and this one in particular, I really, really like a lot.
So guys, how did you feel about our bleach t-shirt project? Now, it was really fun seeing those shirt sleeve stencils in action, so definitely make sure you check out that tutorial to learn how to set those up on your own. But guys, I just really love making these shirts. I think it's a really great way to add character to what can be seen as plain, boring old shirts, right? I love making them for seasonal projects, and if you're into sublimation, make sure you check out our video on how to do these with sublimation, all right? Now, I'm gonna wrap it up for today, guys, but if you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave those below. I love hearing from you guys, and of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel, share with a crafty friend, maybe give it a like or a thumbs up, because that helps us to keep bringing you these videos in the future. So thanks again, guys. I appreciate it, and we will see you again next time.